Amen. Amen. Good morning, church. We would like to welcome you to Exhilarated Outreach Ministry. We would like to acknowledge all our visitors this morning. If this is your first time visiting, we will pass you a visitor's package to fill out the visiting card and tell us all about yourself. Today is the fourth Sunday in our Lord. We want to thank our music director, Mr. Derrick Emerald, for those beautiful selections of praise this morning. Our prayer list remains Sister Felita and family, Sister Francie, House of Prayer Ministries, and our Pastor Kelly and family. Exhilarated Church family, please keep us in prayer. If you know of someone sick and in need of prayer, please contact the secretary mailbox at the entrance of the church. Next Sunday is Fifth Sunday Fellowship. Please come relaxed and dressed down, but appropriate. Our service times are at 11 a.m. SLT every Sunday, Thursdays at House of Prayer, 2 p.m. SLT. These are our announcements, and I am Sister Polka, and I will return you back into the hands of the pulpit. Amen. God bless everybody.
I'm so happy to see y'all this morning, and I'm glad to see y'all because I know God is glad to see you. And I'm so glad nobody came in this place looking to see me. That you came to hear a word from God. Amen. So I bless God for you. Amen. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. So let's get to the word. If you click that box right up under that Bible, the purple box, it has the scriptures for today. Amen. And if you would get that box and get those scriptures, Matthew chapter 19, verse 16 through 20. Matthew chapter 19, verse 16 through 20. And I'm going to try to be quick about it, okay? Another day a man stopped Jesus and asked, "Teacher, what good thing must I do to get eternal life?" Jesus said, "Why do you question me about what's good? God is the one who is good. If you want to enter the life of God, just do what he tells you to do." The man asked, "What is it in particular?" that he asked. Jesus said, "Don't murder, don't commit adultery, don't steal, don't lie, honor your father and mother, and love your neighbor as you do yourself." The young man said, "I've done all that, so what's left?" "If you want to give it all you got," Jesus replied, "go sell your possessions, give everything to the poor, all your wealth, then be in heaven, then come follow me." That was the last thing the young man expected to hear. And so he walked away. He was holding on tight to a lot of things, and he couldn't bear to let it go. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers, to the readers, and most of all to the doers of his holy word. Jesus, let this word come out with fire. Father God, we pray that this word will fall on good grounds. Use me, God. God, let my lips open with your words, God, with your power, with your anointing. And Lord, let these words, this message, fall in open hearts, with open minds, God, with an open spirit to obey your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus answered the questions of a young rich man. The man started by calling Jesus a good teacher, seeking answers for a shortcut into the kingdom of God. Young rich man was looking to Jesus for a cheat sheet to eternal life. When Jesus instructed him to do as God says to do, he then asked Jesus to be specific and to give details. Jesus gave him the quote of the Ten Commandments. Young man said, "Oh, I've done that already. Now what's next?" There are many of us that feels the same that this gentleman does right now, that we have in fact been following the Ten Commandments and headed to the road paved with gold. Well, let's see about that. Let's break down the Ten Commandments. Most of us can say we kept the Ten Commandments according to the scriptures, but not according to our day-to-day actions. The commandment says don't murder. You may not have murdered by gun or your bare hands, but we murder people's character. We verbally put our mouths on folks with sowing discord, backbiting, discouraging the weak and the lost. By giving people a piece of our mind, cussing them out. By being church bullies and just plain out showing your lack of compassion to those in need. My God. Murder to the first degree, spiritually. Running them off and out of God's place of provision. It's no telling how they could have contributed to the upbuilding of the kingdom. It's no telling who they could have been in God. Next commandment, committing adultery against a true and living God. Every time you lay down your religion to get in the flesh, very hard for the new man to come forth when the old man is constantly existing and showing up to give someone a piece of your mind. We better keep that peace of mind because we're going to need it to serve the Lord with. We are cheating on the God we vow to be in season and out of season with. We think if we show up for our serve for the service, any service at that, somebody better be glad about it. If we came on Sunday in appearance, but not in soul and spirit, he doesn't get the glory for that. God don't need body count. Churches do. God wants your repentance, your gratefulness, your praise, your faithfulness to him and only him. Because he is indeed a jealous God that nobody else can possess you over him. Let's look at the next commandment. Don't steal. We were taught at a young age not to touch what didn't belong to you, not to steal from others. So we know that's stealing. Did you know when you buy meat, TVs, computers, clothes, etc. from a guy or a gal named Junior or Tay-Tay off the streets, that's considered stealing? Did you know that? These people don't own a retail store. They stole it from somebody else. Now you are an accessory to a burglar. Stolen products in your home. And if the police trace that serial number, you won't have a receipt to prove you bought it in the right way, because thieves don't give receipts. Also, if you walk out the store with too much extra change by the cashier's mistake, or forget to pay for an item and don't go back to make it right, that's stealing. Days you sitting around, not doing anything when you could be studying the word or praying, you're stealing time from the God who gave you life. Your check may be $735, but your tithe envelope says $30. That's not 10%. That's a gratuity or a tip. The next commandment says don't lie. Today we call what's wrong right and what's right wrong. That's a lie. When we say we love God who we never seen but hate the people we see every day, that's a lie. When we say we have not committed a sin or done wrong to people who we say we love, that's a lie. The Bible declares a thief and a liar will not tarry in the sight of God. We must serve God in spirit and in truth. Honor your parents through your deeds, not your lips. Don't be rebellious. Do better and do right by them. And parents, quit being punks. Children talking back, taking over your home where they don't pay the bills. Won't clean, terrible in school, and you still reward them. The scripture tells every child to obey their parents or their days won't be long. Love your neighbors as you love yourself. This is a catch 22. What if you don't love yourself? Are we then right for treating our neighbors the way we treat ourselves? We have to first love us. Love me. Before you can love others. Because you can't do what you don't know. Do what God tells us to do. Because a little kindness goes a long way. So what's left? What's left, y'all? Since we done went through the Tinkerbell, what is left? The man asked God. He asked Jesus, tell me what's left. So Jesus told him, well, if you want to give it all you got, then go sell all your riches and give it to the poor. If you give away all your earthly possessions, all the wealth you desire will be waiting for you in heaven. Now come follow me. So Jesus is trying to tell us we cannot hold on to the worldly possessions in God too. Why not? Because those things will become your little God. It will take your eyes off of God and his assignments for you. But that's if you're worshiping possessions. They have a lot of rich people that love the Lord and give their time and profits to him. But we are talking about this young rich man and how we are not to follow this example. Once Jesus said these things to him, he walked away. If you ask people to walk away from their houses and cars today, they will ask you if you bumped your head. Tell them Jesus wants you to sell your cars and houses, give the money to the poor, and follow him. People will tell you no way, and that Jesus knows my heart. Yes, he does, and that's why he knows your love for him is second place to your possessions. Amen. Y'all with me? Glory to God. Y'all look, y'all with me? Hallelujah. The man walked away because he didn't understand why he couldn't just have it all. He worked so hard to have these things. It's not so easy to let go of the world when it clearly offers me so much. Why can't I just have it all? Adam and Eve felt the same way in the garden. The Lord gave them every tree in the garden to eat off of except one tree. And that tree bothered them the most. Why can't I eat off that tree too? Why can't I just have it all? Many people wish they could be so much like other countries with a harem of spouses at one time. Why not? Why can't I have it all? There is a whole lot of me to go around. Why not? Because we have to stand in judgment one day. And God will question us, why didn't we do what he told us to do? Why didn't you say what I told you to say? And why didn't you preach what I told you to preach? Why didn't you reach the people that I told you to reach? So, church, I come to realize that only what we do for Christ will last. So why didn't you go feed the hungry, clothe the naked, visit the prisoners, visit the sick? We got to be very careful, church, of how we treat people. You got to be very careful how you treat the widows and the elderly. Be careful of how we treat each other. We have to do what God is telling us to do. God will show you people that he wants you to bless. Don't just let good food sit in the freezer to get freezer burnt. Share it with somebody who probably don't even know what it is to have good meat, fresh fruits, and vegetables. Clothes in our closets rotting away. Bless the naked. Some will say, if I give all my things away, what's left? A clean heart with the right spirit is what's left. A renewed mind willing to obey the Lord is what's left. I stop by to tell somebody today that serving the Lord will pay off after a while. Amen. That's the title of my message today. Serving the Lord will pay off after a while. Hallelujah. Some people feel like the prodigal son. I want mine right now. I don't want it to pay off after a while. Ain't nobody going to be able to see me if I go to heaven and wait for my riches in heaven. Ain't nobody down there. I want all my friends to see me. I want all my family to see me. I want to bless my family with money. I want to one day and somehow come through for my family. I want my daddy to know that I worked something. I want my mama to see that I did something with my life. Possessions ain't going to tell her that. Having money ain't going to tell your father that. Sons trying to prove their fathers that they were wrong when you called me no good. You said I wasn't going to amount to nothing. Daughters trying to prove to their mothers that you were wrong. I'm not going to be a prostitute all my life. I am going to take care of my children. I'm going to stop doing drugs. Everybody wants to prove something to somebody. But nobody is trying to be the person that God asks you to be. Serving the Lord will pay off after a while. As I get ready to go to my seat, I just want to tell somebody to just be patient. God sees your deeds in Him. I know you're feeling like nothing is going your way, but hold on a little while longer. Your tomorrow is coming. I know you're tired of seeing other people blessed. I know you're tired of hearing other people testify about good fortunes. I know you're seeing the just and the unjust being rained on. And sometimes you wonder, what's left for me? Everything. There's 1,000 cattle on the hill just for you. There's a place right now being prepared just for you. A mansion not made by man's hands. Streets paved with real gold, the purest of it. That's what's left. Jesus trying to tell you, come follow me into tomorrow. Don't you want to go? Wouldn't you like to be with the man that's been carrying you through life all this time? The man whose footprints were in the sand when yours wasn't, because he was carrying you? How wonderful will that day be? We will cease from troubling. Sickness will be no more. You won't have to cry no more. All your bills will be paid. There will be no more mortgages and rent to pay in heaven. The debts have already been paid for that. He paid the ransom so you could have eternal life with Him. Come on, y'all. Don't you want to go? I know I do. What's left, my brothers? What's left, my sisters? Life in Christ Jesus. Keep on serving the Lord. Stay on the wall and don't come down from your assignment to dwell in foolishness. I'm here to tell somebody that serving the Lord will pay off after a while. You ain't always be broke with this little meagre nickels and change. God have you. But if you just put your trust in Him, when you come to the altar today, I want you to leave all your troubles there. Don't pick them up. Don't take them with you. Don't even take a thought of what you will eat tomorrow. Don't take a thought of what you would wear or how you're going to pay your bills. If you continue to serve the Lord and let God handle your issues, your problems, and your concerns, He's a yoke destroyer. He's a burden bearer. He's a heavy load sharer. He will carry you through this world, through all your problems and concern. You're feeling lonely? You want somebody in your life? Talk to God. God will do it. He'll give you something brand new. God don't bless people with other people's husbands and with other people's wives. Amen? If I had any kind of voice before I let my sister come up here and sing, but if I had a singing voice like she has, and if I could sing anything today, I would say, in times like this, You need a savior in times like this. You need an anchor. Be very sure. Be very sure that your anchor holds and that it grips a solid rock. That rock is Jesus. Come on to the altar, y'all. Yes, he is the one. That rock is Jesus. Come on, somebody. He is the only one. Be very sure. Be very sure that your anchor holds. And it grips a solid rock. Hallelujah. Come on to the altar. Somebody may be saying, I was just thinking that last week of how my bills is overriding my monies. I was just saying that last week. My neighbor and them keep getting new cars and they're getting this and I don't know how they're getting it. But God, I sure want it. Somebody was just saying last week, I don't have enough. I'm tired of not having enough. Somebody was just saying the other day, God, I can't take it with all of my family members dying off, my friends. God, I don't know what to do. I'm unsure of my life. And if somebody just wanted to thank God for blessing them, where we're living in a world where many people don't have jobs, and you still have yours? Somebody just really want to thank God. So come on to the altar as my sister. Come on with her song. Amen. Come on with your song, sweetie. Amen. And if you're trying to put it in the stream, give it to Brother Derrick, and he will change your stream for you. And as she prepared to sing, I want everybody to just think on these things. What's left? What can you do to better your life with God? Amen. Think about what's left. Is all of this junk down here worth your soul? Is all of that stuff really worth it? Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we ask for forgiveness if we've ever looked over you for possessions. Father God, if you've ever put it on our hearts when we walked past the homeless or we walked past that drunk man or that young man that we know he's probably living homeless somewhere and we didn't even offer to help him. Father God, if we are full of food in our house and we don't see the need to offer it to somebody else, God, forgive us for every time we fixed a plate of food and didn't finish it all and threw it in the trash. That was a portion somebody could have eaten. Somebody on the homeless and hungry would have been glad to get. God, forgive me if I'm being selfish. Lord, forgive me if my lustful ways is taken over, that I feel like I need more than one person to love me at a time. Lord, forgive me if I've walked away from you with money in my pocket and not offer the 10% that you asked us for. Lord, forgive me if I've never made a sacrifice, but you've made a sacrifice for me by offering up your son to die in my stead. Lord, bless me to be the parent that I need to be to ungrateful children or to ungrateful grandchildren or to ungrateful siblings, ungrateful friends. Well, we can even have parents that are ungrateful to us and just want to put the blame on us for everything, but not taking responsibility for the ways that we were taught, the way they brought us up. Lord, forgive me for all the anger that I've had against a person that assaulted me. Lord, let me forgive them so that I could be forgiven of my sins. God, cause me to let go some stuff. In the name of Jesus. Yes, God, I'm in grief right now, God. But I know your word says that weeping may endure for a night and joy cometh in the morning. I need my morning, God, to come. I need my morning to come, God. God, I bless you for every soul in this place. And I thank you for everything that is going on in their life right now, God. That their tomorrow will come. If they put their trust in you today, their tomorrow will come. We thank you right now for all those, God, that have made a sacrifice to be here today. We bless you for everything that they've ever given. We thank you for everything that they're saying, that their hearts being open in their mind to receive you today. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, sister, with your song. Are you ready? Put a one in local for me if you're ready. Amen. All right. Return to your streams, everyone. For a song and then after. Oh, and locally. Okay. After this song, we will dismiss. Give her your attention, please. God bless you.
God, for giving me my heart's desire, I always say, and if you've been here as long as I've been on SL, you know that things change and people come and go, and at sometimes you might find yourself longing for some constants, people you knew before, and just to make it feel like, you know, home again. And I just thank God for this constant, spiritual constant that we have here. And I actually knew that she was going to ask me to sing after the message, not because, you know, she told me or I had some type of telepathy, but because of the song that God gave me. I don't have any music for this, so I'm going to try to do this without it. And pray for me. There is a sweet anointing in this sanctuary. There is a stillness in the atmosphere. Oh, come lay down the burdens you have carried, for in the sanctuary God is here. No, there is a sweet anointing in the sanctuary. There is a sense in the atmosphere. Oh, come lay down the burdens you have carried. For in the sanctuary, God is here. Oh, come lay down the burdens you have carried. For in the sanctuary, God is here. Maybe you sit there and you sing, and you want to say it right now to yourself. He is here. God is here. To break the yoke and lift the heavy burdens. He is here. God is here. To heal the hopeless heart and bless the broken. Oh, come lay down the burdens you have carried. God is here. Last ending of the song says that you want him to speak. To say to yourself, as I know the doors of this church are open, if he's speaking to you through the message, just say, speak, Lord, speak. Oh, speak, Lord, speak. Just say to yourself as I go back to my seat, speak, Lord, speak. Oh, speak, Lord, speak.
We thank God for each and every one of you. God bless. And we'll see you upon the next appointed time. Keep me in prayer as I keep you in prayer. Amen. God bless. You're dismissed.
Christian, listen to this. I've had my share.